Today we're here to celebrate the Read Across Georgia Month, and I will be formalizing that with a resolution here in just a minute. But I begin by simply expressing my appreciation to the Department of Early Child Care and Learning, who are the ones who are carrying forward on this Get Georgia Reading effort. To Commissioner Jacobs and to her team, thank you all very much for trying to make sure that every child is reading and growing in our state. We take far too many things for granted, of course. For instance, we expect that all students should be able to read on third grade level before they leave the third grade. But unfortunately, only about a third of Georgia students are currently able to do that. We've increased that percentage, but we still have work to do. From kindergarten through the third grade, we're told that children learn to read. From the third grade on, they read to learn. So if we want them to be prepared for the world that awaits outside the schoolhouse doors, then we have to give them the means for reaching their potential.
Thank you very much, Governor Deal. I want to say on behalf of Georgia's youngest learners and us at the Department of Early Care and Learning, we thank you for proclaiming March as Read Across Georgia Month. This is one of our favorite months of the year at the department. And we are always proud to join with you, Governor, and the First Lady again to remind Georgians about the importance of early literacy and reading to children in our schools, our child care learning programs, and most importantly, in our homes. These topics of literacy and the importance of reading that Governor and Mrs. Deal have championed since he took office 6 years ago are ideas that educators and leaders have valued and emphasized for generations.
I chose to read the book by Coy Bowles. Now, Coy plays music with the Zac Brown Band. And most of you have heard of the Zac Brown Band because they've made great impressions for Georgia all over the world, and we're proud of them. But in addition to helping write the songs and perform the music, Coy has written two children's books and is working on a third. But I've been reading this book about Will Powers. It's the story of a little boy who really wants to perform in a talent show, but the teacher says, you're just not good enough.
So over the last 8 years, my life has just been an amazing journey. It's like getting strapped to a rocket and blasting off. From winning 3 Grammys, numerous country music awards. But this book is kind of a reflection of my life. I tried out for middle school band when I was in 7th grade, and believe it or not, did not make it. And I went back, and later that year I started playing guitar, and I was kind of, all my friends were going and playing in drumline in 6th and 7th and 8th grade, and I was kind of sitting at home, and I didn't get to be a part of that musical experience. And so it kind of drove me to practice the guitar more. So when I was doing Will Powers, I really wanted to make sure that the issue that I tackled was very pertinent to what was going on in the school systems and with kids today. I taught guitar lessons for about six to eight years before I got in the Zac Brown Band, and that was my form of income. So I spent a lot of time in the classroom with kids and just learned to love that sharing and being the teacher-student relationship. I'm so excited for this book. I'm so excited to meet the Deal family, and I got to meet her daughter yesterday. I was here for promoting the Georgia Music Appreciation Day, and I'm very excited for this book to come out. I hope that everybody can pass along the word, if you don't mind. And we came up with, Mrs. Deal, who's full of cool ideas, came up with this idea for sending signed copies to all the other First Ladies of the United States. So we have 49 copies of this book going out to all the First Ladies to promote Read Across America. Yeah, it's really cool.
We recognize how important reading is. And now fast forwarding to my position as state school superintendent, you know, one of the things that I had a passion for was literacy. But I would say this, that, you know, I'm very blessed and honored that as in coming to this position, I actually had a couple, Governor Deal and Mrs. Deal, who had the foresight of saying literacy is important. Now, they have made my job very easy. And that, you know, the commitment here is that I'm very pleased to say that, that these two individuals have done more to advance reading in our state than any first couple that I can remember. So thank you very much, and again, I wish you the best, and always keep reading. Thank you.